guys, my girlfriend, she locked me in here. I don't want her to hear anything. You know, hopefully she doesn't come in and, you know, starts bothering me and stuff, you know. But I'm gonna do a show to work out, but I'm gonna try to figure out a way to get out of here. So let's hope much for the best. Wait, no! All right, what is up, YouTube? What's good with y'all? Back at it today. I'm about to hit a shoulder workout. I'm about to head out my crib real quick, and I'm about to go pump up these shoulders for y'all. Get some tricep action too. You know, this is my second video. This is really the first video where you guys are gonna hear me talk. So I'm about to head downstairs and show you guys what we got going on today. All right, I'm finally back. I finally made it downstairs. I had to kind of walk backwards going downstairs because yesterday I had a killer leg day, but that's besides the point. Today, we're gonna be doing a shoulder workout. As I mentioned before, I'm gonna start out with some front delt action, get my side delts. I'm gonna hop on this cable machine behind me for my rear delts because, you know, if you have muscles, you gotta work the over and round muscle. You can't just, you know, work the front and the side delt and neglect the back delt, because a lot of guys neglect the back delt. And it's almost like looking at I'm gonna use women for example. It's almost like looking at a woman from the front, and you know, she has all these nice curves and, you know, the symmetry and everything is perfect. And then all of a sudden she turns around and she looks like a flat sheet of paper. Like, come on now. So don't be those type of people, you know? Or it's just like the guys that have a really good upper body, but you know, they have little skinny chicken legs. It just doesn't look right. It's not the aesthetic look. So today we're gonna get after it. And then later on, I'm also gonna work on a little bit of my triceps as well. I'm gonna do some katana extensions and maybe a little bit of skull crushers with the dumbbells over here. But without further ado, let's get started. All right guys, so first things first, I usually start out with a lightweight, like maybe 5 pounds or 10 pounds, something really light, something I can barely feel. And I just kind of feel it. Oh my God, look at those shoulders, those round, broad shoulders. That's gonna be a strong man one day. All right, and now you're gonna see me do some side delt raises. I wanna feel the muscles swell up, just like Arnold Schwarzenegger would say. I wanna feel the blood swell up, and I want the stretch of the muscle, the full contraction, because that's the only way that the muscle's gonna grow. Rear delt action. It's just like the lady with the flat sheet of paper analogy. You don't want to have too round of shoulders, but you want to also have a back shoulder too, because people walk behind you. They don't just see the front of you, they also see the back of you. So please keep in mind that you do not want to use a heavy weight when performing this exercise, because you will definitely mess up your shoulder, and that would be an expensive hospital bill. And yes, from time to time, I will pick up some heavier dumbbells. Not too heavy, though, like maybe like 25 pounders. I will sit my big behind down, and I will definitely do some front raises and sometimes some side raises as well. But in this part, I just do front raises because I just feel too lazy to do the sides. Psych, I lied. I did do some side raises, but I stood up instead of sat down because it was just less boring that way. I get bored really fast. I hope you guys figure that out like really sooner than later, because other than that, you know, it's gonna be kind of funny for you guys to figure that out later. Not to also mention, I was starting to get a cramp midway through the workouts.
So I kind of had to improvise for you guys just a little bit. I tried to hold in the pain, but you can just look at the facial expressions that I was making that this was very painful because, well, it was. I'm not sure what type of viewers I have out there, but this is to verify that I did up the weight. Alright guys, so I'm back on the cables because I'm doing some more rear delt flies. Once again, you know, I want to have a nice backside, man. You know, I want to have a nice back shoulder. So if I ever do a beach video one day, which I'm pretty sure I will, you know, my back shoulder will definitely be revealed. And the rest of my back will also be more aesthetic as well. I didn't tear a muscle there. No, I'm just kidding, guys. I didn't tear a muscle, but I did up the weight just a little bit just so I can feel just a little more sore because I'm getting ready to get into dumbbell presses and barbell presses on the Smith machine. So I just wanted to get just a little bit of blood flowing in my shoulders. Now, as I get into my barbell presses, I usually start out with no weight at all, just so I can get a feel for the stretch of the muscle around my shoulders and to make sure that I fully contract and get a full stretch before I even add any type of weight to the bar. And also, if you guys didn't know, when you bring the bar behind your back, you also work out your rear delts as well. So just keep that in mind. Alright guys, this is nearing the end of my shoulder workout, and I'm not gonna lie, I just did like 15 sets before I even started touching any type of heavy weight like this, so my shoulders are in a lot of pain right now. So finally for these barbells, I put on about 185 on the bar, and now I'm just basically pushing it on the overdrive at this point because I am really tired. Alright guys, so this is the final exercise of the day. I like to do Arnold presses at the end of my exercise. I can see why Arnold loved this exercise because you definitely get to contract your scapula completely and then you press up with the medium to heavy weight. I picked up some 45s, usually like I do 50s, but after I did that 185 press, I'm pretty bent out of shape. So.
Alright, so this is not how I wanted to end my video today, but I'm going to end my video today on this note. Now, it's been brought to my attention. I watched the news today for the first time in months. You know, and I just keep seeing people commit suicide. Now, the reason why this topic is on my chest today is because about a month ago, one of my old buddies from high school had committed suicide. And it bothers me because people never really beg to ask the question, why? Like, why does this stuff happen to people, man? Like, I understand people have bad things, but people, they don't necessarily talk about this stuff. And one of the main reasons why I had previously went to an institution, and one of the reasons why I had left that institution was because every single year somebody was trying to commit suicide. I hate that this is a doom and gloom topic, but I gotta speak about this because it's an issue and it's a problem that people need to start talking about. And especially this goes out there to my men, because most suicides come from men ages between 18 to 30. Because life is hard, man. Like, life is really hard out here for everybody. It's hard out here for me and for the rest of the guys that are out here, you know? It's terrible. And I'm speaking for all the men out there. Ladies, this is for you too, but mainly this is for the guys. You know, just talk to somebody, man. Talk to somebody. Please talk to somebody. You know, don't be silent and keep all that stuff balled up inside, because either you're gonna retaliate when you've had enough, you're gonna take it out on somebody else, or you're gonna hurt yourself and take it out on yourself. And I'm tired of seeing that happen, especially to all my men out there, man. I mean, you know, like, when we look at the world, who built it for the most part? You know, who put in the physical labor for all this stuff? And then we're gonna sit back and kill ourselves? No, man. Don't kill yourself. I understand that the world is a precedence, and we do have a ticking top clock on our lives, but don't kill yourself, man. Don't let life succumb to you, and let people come to you. And on another note too, this message also goes out, you know, mainly to black men, you know, because I'm a black man myself, and I'm not afraid to recognize that. And, you know, I just understand that life is, it's extra hard for us because of, you know, societal roles and societal pressures that come from black men, you know. Drugs in our community, lack of black leadership taking action within our communities, and there's really no incentive for us to really go to school. And I get it. I mean, I'm currently in school, but I know that a lot of black guys my age aren't in school. You know, they're out selling drugs and gangbanging, and I get it because of the communities that we grow up in. And nobody cares about us. It's just like the Michael Jackson song. They don't really care about us. It's the same thing for our community too. Like, nobody really cares. And I just want to be that type of person to say that it's okay to go to school. You know, now don't use it as a crutch or anything to get by in life, but it's okay to go to school. It's okay to get an education. It's okay to do your own thing in life too. Just don't let it be against the law. Don't let it get you in any trouble or behind bars or anything. Because you can't take back 20 years of your life. I'm not saying that you have to go to school, because you don't really have to go to school to make it in order to get by in life, to have a successful life. You don't have to. And if you ever read my description of my channel, I always talk about stay true to yourself. And don't let anybody sway you from it. Like, if you want to be a baker, be a baker. You know what I mean? Like, if you want to bake. If you want to be a fast race car driver, then be that. If you want to be a musician, go ahead and be that. Shit, if you want to be a fisherman, do that. But just figure out a way how to monetize yourself and, you know, get your name and your image out there. You know, these things in life, they're not going to come back again. These years, these young years of our lives, we're not ever going to get it back ever again. So we just got to take advantage of what we have now and all of our resources and succeed. Don't let anyone ever tell you guys you can't do something. You can't lift 500 pounds. I remember when I was in class and someone told me I would never be able to bench press 315. I can bench 315 now. I'll never be able to squat or put 500 pounds on my back. I just put 500 on my back the other day. Don't let anyone tell you you can't do something, that you can't accomplish it. And if they do tell you that, make sure you not only do what they said that you couldn't do, but you surpass that. Got some more content coming next week for you guys. I'm not gonna lie, I have been inspired by a lot of these celebrities and their workouts and what they've been doing. That's really what mainly got me into fitness and stuff. So, you know, one of my favorite actors right now, probably my favorite actor right now, he's up and coming. I'm definitely gonna train like him for a day. So please stay tuned for that, guys, and catch you guys in my next few videos.